Last week, the Commission of Animal Health directed authorities in 32 districts to enforce quarantine due to an outbreak of foot and mouth disease in areas of the cattle corridor and other cattle keeping districts. However, this has not gone well with legislators from the affected areas.
You are issuing total quarantine on animals and animal products. In my constituents of Kazo and Chiruhura, they entirely depend on animals for survival. Honorable Speaker, what hurts me most is that the Commission are issuing these quarantines is seated in Entebbe. From the time the outbreak happened, she has not stepped, not even part of her technical team, to come and assess.
I can clearly understand where Honorable Chimoso is coming from. Our people, many of them, these animals is their livelihood. I want to support your guidance that the Minister of Agriculture should come on the floor of Parliament and report and make a statement so that the nation is guided.
During today's House sitting, a section of Members of Parliament, led by the Kazo County Legislator, Dan Atujukire Kimosho, went up in arms against the Minister of Agriculture, alleging an unfair imposition of quarantine in the region.
My prayer, right honourable Speaker, is that my first prayer is that the Ministry should consider amendment of this law.
Because when I've looked at the districts where they are trying to quarantine, they've left out all the districts of Acholi. I'm suspecting that they are now saying that the Balaros in Acholi, please don't move, because the rest of the country has foot and mouth disease.
The affected districts include Bukedia, Luwero, Kasanda, Kumi, Mbarara, Nakaseke, Gomba, Yisingiro, Kazo, Kayunga, Mitiana, Mpiji, Kiruhura, Fort Poto, and Sembable, among others. Kimosho prayed that the government compensate affected farmers whose livelihood depends on animals, yet they're about to take their children back to school.
There should be a consideration by this government to compensate people for what they lose out of its failure to do its responsibility.
Lawmakers pointed to delayed vaccination of the disease as a factor that has escalated the disease countrywide.
You find another DC issues a permission for someone to move animals, and that has caused serious problems. So I want to request that we amend his prayers and also include that the veterinary services in this country be re-centralized.
The Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayeba, who chaired the sitting, faulted the Minister of Agriculture for causing unnecessary crisis in the country by not consulting leaders before imposing the quarantine.
Such a program, when you have such interventions, use a platform of Parliament to come here and you engage, because these members of Parliament will be questioned in their constituencies. They will be stuck. And again, as Parliament, you don't want to have a situation whereby one day you will be accused that we are fighting FMD, we put a quarantine, you Parliament, you came, you said stop it, therefore we are out, and it went on. That's why I had felt that it would be imperative for the Minister to bring a statement here. Then we debate a statement.
In this regard, the House gave the Minister of Agriculture, Animal Industry and Fisheries to carry out a scientific accountability. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.